Hey guys and girls, welcome back to the History of Digital Currency mini-series. This is part 2. Just to recap into last week, we learned about David Charm, a computer scientist and cryptographer who introduced the idea of digital currency in a research paper he wrote in 1983, which I have added a link to it in the description below if you're interested. Then he went on to found DigiCash in Amsterdam. However, that filed for bankruptcy in 1998, the reason for, he says, was because e-commerce hadn't been fully integrated into the internet yet. We then went on to talking about e-gold, which is a digital currency backed by real gold to secure its monetary value. However, that was shut down by the United States government, hey Uncle Sam, after the platform was exploited by the underworld. We then talked about the Liberty Reserve, which was again shut down by the United States government for the same reason as e-gold, having too much illegal activity on the platform. And I pointed out that the biggest problem for digital currencies in the rise of e-gold and Liberty Reserve was the fact that it was a centralized ledger, which meant that it could be shut down, unlike the cryptocurrencies that we currently have today. We also touched on QQ coin from China and PayPal. Alright. That's enough of an introduction. My name is Jake Elwins, and this is Millionaire Mindset Hub. Alright, let's get into it. So, we talked about what we discussed last week in the introduction to this video. And now, our mini-series leads us to 9 years ago in 2008, just as the financial world was melting down around us, something beautiful shined. A paper describing digital currencies and the foundations of a new currency appeared by an unknown person or group who goes by the name of Satoshi Nakamoto. Just an FYI, if you're interested in that paper, I have linked to it in the description box below. This paper described a currency that wouldn't have a central ledger system. This feature would completely disable the government's ability to shut it down, just like how they did with e-gold and Liberty Reserve. The new currency would also be able to process transactions within 10 minutes between accounts, which was unheard of in the central ledger system world, as these same transactions would usually take days or weeks to send money around the world. The new currency was designed so that everyone had the same rights under the new financial system where their accounts couldn't be shut down. There would be no delay of transactions taking place and that no one could tamper with or influence the system. This currency was made by the people, for the people. This currency also didn't incur additional fees as there was no need for a middleman such as Visa or banks, which are both known to cripple businesses and retail for their outrageous additional fees. So, what was the currency they envisioned? Well, that currency is Bitcoin. Bitcoin was conceptualized and put together in 2008, however the currency wasn't actually developed and didn't come out until 2009. And after it came out in 2009, for years, the currency was only talked about and used within high-level thinkers such as mathematicians and also the underworld, such as hackers and people who used Bitcoin for dark web market transactions to buy services and products such as illegal drugs or weapons online because it is difficult to trace the transaction. Bitcoin didn't really take off until mid to late 2016, 8 years after Bitcoin was conceptualized, but 7 years after being built, when the mass market and investors poured in. We won't go into the details of why the currency exploded and people started to throw money at it in this video because it's such a big topic, but we're going to be looking into that within a separate video. And if you'd like to check out the graph that shows Bitcoin's explosive growth since 2016, I've put a link to it in the description below. It's important to mention that Bitcoin does have some significant issues, such as privacy, since transactions can be traced, and another issue is its high validity of its value. Because of these two reasons, and because people simply thought that they could do better, people started to create their own currencies, which are called altcoins. In 2011, the first altcoin, which was named Namecoin, was created. Its unique difference is that it was able to store data within its blockchain. Some other altcoins, which you may be familiar with, are Dogecoin, Monero, and Ethereum. And in fact, Vladimir Putin and the Russian government endorsed Ethereum's blockchain technology, which just shows how powerful these currencies and blockchains are becoming, not only to high-level mathematicians and hackers, but to major world governments and the financial industry. Hey guys and girls, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If it provided you with any value and you feel that way inclined, please hit that subscribe button and like the video. If you've got any questions or just want to reach out and say hi, feel free to comment below or PM me. Again, thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you in the next episode.